वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ सम्राट टेक्नोलॉजीज। आज का जो हमारा टॉपिक है दैट इज सीवी राइटिंग स्किल्स। बिकॉज अगर हम इंटरव्यू में जाते हैं तो सबसे पहले इंटरव्यू हमारा क्या देखते हैं, सीवी देखते हैं, रिज्यूमे देखते हैं। सो वी आर जज बाय द सीवी दैट हाउ वी आर मैंशनिंग द इन्फॉर्मेशन और हाउ वी आर फॉर्मेटिंग द सीवी, राइट। सो लेट्स बिगिन, व्हाट आर द की पॉइंट्स वी शुड ऐड। द वेरी फर्स्ट की पॉइंट इज डू योर रिसर्च। The very first step to consider comes well before you start writing your CV is researching your target roles. You must research that what the company is looking for, what are the skills they want in an employee. So you should mention that in your CV. Next is break text up. Huge chunks of text are off-putting for readers and make it difficult for the recruiters to pick out the information they need. Obviously, if we are reading any paragraph, it's difficult to take out the information, right? But if it is mentioned in the bullet points, then it becomes easy. So you must mention all the things in the bullet points, not in a long paragraph. Next is add a punchy profile. It's very important because at the very first, when an interviewer opens your resume, what comes is your profile. So it should be short, but it should be impressive. The top of your CV is very important, so keep it short but impressive. Next is core skills section. It should include anything from industry experience and qualification to skills and IT knowledge. For example, customer service, banking and retail, complaint handling, or fluent in any other language. So you must mention the skills, and it should also be mentioned in the form of bullet points, not in the form of long paragraphs. Okay, the next is use a professional email address. You must use a professional email address. For example, you must mention your name, not like this badboy@thisrate.com or angelpriya@thisrate.com. You must have a professional email address. Every part of your CV will be judged by employees, so it needs to reflect professionalism. Don't use, as I told you, don't use that emails, but you should be using your professional email, which begins with your name. Give a high-level summary of your roles. Provide the details of your previous roles so that they can see how your work feeds into overall success. You must mention your roles, that you have done this and you have worked over here, so it will be impressive. Avoid generic words as such team player and hardworking. You know, you must not mention all these words. If you are mentioning, you must consider an example and then relate to this. You must not only mention team player or hardworking, but relate example. This may impress at first, but they don't tell anything factual about you. So you must not use as such generic words. Use a simple font on CV. If you are writing the CV, you must use a simple font. Add a professional title. Head up at the top of the CV with a professional title next to your name to instantly show recruiters what type of candidate you are. For example, if you are applying for IELTS trainer, you must mention your name and then /IELTS trainer. It will be look professional. Do not add a photo to your CV. Never add a photo to your CV because it doesn't look professional. Next is include a plenty of detail on your current or most recent role. You must add a detail on the recent role you have worked or in the recent company you have worked. You must add detail. Avoid using skills graph. Use professional language. Your CV should be gleaming example of your written communication skills, so to ensure to write in a professional manner. Of course, you know you are judged by each and everything. So in the CV, your language must be professional. There must not be any obsessive language. It should be professional in each and every word, okay? The next is, it's very important, be truthful. You must be truthful. Don't be tempted to falsify qualifications or make up the jobs that you have not done. Don't write false information or about anything you have not done. A white lie may get thrown to interview stage, but the interviewer could quite easily catch you out if you don't appear to know what you are talking about. So don't add false information. Hope so this is helpful to you. Do like and share. And for more videos like this, please press bell icon. Thank you very much.